Welcome to Unity of Wilmington. I'm Reverend Dr. Ellen Contente, and I invite you all to stand and sing our opening song with our congregation celebration singers. Take it away.
Good morning, everybody, and welcome. Welcome to you in the room and to you online. Welcome to Unity of Wilmington, our vibrant spiritual home. We'll start our service today with our mission statement. Unity of Wilmington is a vibrant, loving spiritual community, expanding consciousness and personal transformation. And from that flows our vision, which is united in love, the world celebrates joy, abundance, and harmony. And now we say our statement of belief. There is only one presence and one power active in the universe and in my life, God, the good omnipotence. And our three affirmations flow from that. I am a beloved expression of God. I am here for a holy purpose. I am in the right place at the right time, right now. And before we read our daily word, I neglected to introduce the people serving with me today. So sound and PowerPoint, we have Jose Antonio. Our youth education leader today is Michelle DeRocher. Our hospitality team is Gail O'Brien and Bill DeRocher. Our welcome team, Donna DeGutis and Betty McCain. Let's see, who else do we have? Our prayer partner and daily word reader, Teresa Rodriguez, right there. Our music director, Katie Dees. And our vocalist today is Nick Steigerwald. Our co-minister giving the lesson today is the Reverend Dr. Ellen Contente. And now as Teresa comes up to read the daily word, I would like to mention that we do have those for sale at the church. You can also purchase them online, and they also offer an online version where you can get it in your inbox every day if you prefer the digital version. And now Teresa.
Thank you, Shirley. Good morning. Today is June 23rd. We're into summer, and the daily word is generous. And if we would say the affirmation together, I honor the divinity in others through my generosity. There have been times when I relied on the generosity of others. I remember feeling grateful when they shared what they had with open hearts, not thinking of how I might repay their kindness. This is the true gift of generosity. not just the material offered or the services rendered, but the feeling I am worthy of someone's time, treasure, and effort. This love and compassion is at the heart of my generous impulses, too. I give not out of pity or even out of obligation or duty, but so others may know their worthiness through me. Each person is a divine being made in the image and likeness of God. I honor each person's divinity by doing what I can to help and support them as others have helped and supported me. From Proverbs chapter 22, verse 9, those who are generous are blessed, for they share the bread with the poor.
Well, thank you, Teresa. So in that space and feeling of generosity, let's move into our meditation. So I invite everybody just to get comfortable in your seat, close your eyes, and take a nice, long, slow, deep breath in and release. Generosity, being generous, giving to others just because they are worthy. And I want you to hold in mind this idea of worthiness. What does it mean to be worthy? Breathing in, releasing any tension, any charge that word brings up for you. We are all worthy. And silently think to yourself, I am worthy. I am worthy of love. I am worthy of friendship. I am worthy of peace. I am worthy of prosperity, and I am worthy of joy. And allowing that feeling of joy to be joyful, allow that feeling to be fully present. Be generous with yourself. Do not hold back. And hold a vision right now of joy. Breathing in. Breathing out. See yourself jumping for joy. And that generosity, both to yourself and spreading that joy to others. It starts to expand even further and further. The more joyful you become, the more joy you give out, and the more joy comes back. So let's just hold for a moment in silence, in a joyful state of mind. Take another deep breath in and release, knowing that this feeling of joy and generosity is always present. It is who you are, and you can never be separated from it because it is a divine expression of God, and that is who you are. And joy is your birthright. And so let's slowly start to bring our awareness back to this present moment. You could go ahead and wiggle your fingers and your toes. And when you're ready, just open up your eyes. And it is so in this joyful moment, it is my joyful opportunity to invite Nick to come up and sing for us. Let's give him a round of applause.
A pencil, pizza with sausage, telling the time. Happiness is learning to whistle, tying your shoe for the very first time. Happiness is playing the drum in your own school band. And happiness is walking hand in hand. Happiness is knowing a secret, new kinds of ice cream, climbing a tree. Happiness is five different crayons, catching a firefly, setting him free. Happiness is being alone every now and then, and happiness is coming home again. Happiness is morning and evening, daytime and nighttime too, for happiness is anyone and anything at all that's loved by you.
That was pure happiness. Beautiful. And thank you, Katie. That was wonderful playing as well. I mean, he hit everything in that song that I was going to talk about, so I think we're done. I mean, we are done. Oh, my goodness. So, happiness. And, you know, today's talk is called Jumping for Joy, and it is energy month, so I can't think of anything else. Well, there's a lot of things that give us energy, but jumping, and certainly jumping for joy, can bring a lot of energy to us. When was the last time you jumped on a bed? Anyone? I'm looking around the room. When I put that picture up there, that was my third choice. I kept looking at different photos that represented jumping for joy, and I was like, you know what? That's just pure joy right there, and it just brought back so many memories from when my kids would jump on the bed. And of course, as a parent, you're saying, don't jump on the bed, because why? We're afraid they're going to fall off and hit their heads, and you know, you're going to end up in the emergency room, which is how my brother ended up with a few stitches in his head. But jumping for joy, you know, joy is part of who we are. It is one of our powers, which is zeal. The Unity 12 powers, one of the powers is zeal. And so zeal and energy and joy, to me, they're all interrelated. So zeal is great enthusiasm and energy. Great enthusiasm and energy. And one of the best ways to feel that is to be joyful. And, you know, joy is happiness, but it's great happiness that stems from something that you connect with, something you enjoy doing. It's caused by something good or something that delights you. So even though we talk about happiness being a state of mind, you know, there are things out there that do make us feel more joyful, right? Right, jumping on the bed, learning to tie our shoes for the first time, just reading a good book, just watching the sunrise, the sunset, and thank you, Teresa, once again, sent me a beautiful picture of the sunset. So, you know, to experience joy, I mean, who wants to live a joyless life? Does anybody want to live a joyless life? Who wants more joy? More joy. Ernest Holmes said, "You, like all others, are seeking the joy of living." Just living can be joyful, can be joyful. So I'm going to challenge us today, and the rest of the month, and the rest of the year, and truthfully, the rest of our lives, to be joyful no matter what, right? We can definitely be joyful for the good stuff, but can we be joyful through the bad stuff? Can we be joyful no matter what? So when you walk out there and it's 1,000% humidity and your hair either goes shh, or goes like this, can you still be joyful? That's what I'm going to challenge us with. So our affirmation today is, oh boy, I am jumping for joy. And if you want to stand up and jump, go for it. Ready, everybody? Oh boy, I am jumping for joy. Woo! I didn't practice that, so I'm glad nothing fell off. So, just like last week, I'm going to go with the flow of three parts of a lesson. So, lesson one, or part one, don't wait to be joyful. Don't wait to be joyful. I mean, I know sometimes it's hard to be joyful when there's so much going on in the world, in our communities, in our own, you know, families. Or we say, you know what, I will wait, you know, I'll be happy when I retire. There's a lot of retired people here. Are you happy? Yeah. Yeah, oh yeah. Or maybe that wasn't a good example. I'll be happy when I lose the weight. I'll be happy when I gain the muscle. I'll be happy when. We put all these conditions on happiness, and we don't need to do that. You know, in our own Unity community, you know, we have people dealing with cancer. We have people that have had car accidents. We have people that are dealing with chronic illness. We have people that, you know, broke bones. We have people that are walking around with walking pneumonia and colds and flus. So we could say, oh, well, we have nothing to be joyful for. Look at how awful our lives are. I just watched a movie. Senate invited folks to come see a movie about what's going on in Palestine. And, you know, walking out of that movie, and we hope to bring it here to Unity for all of us to see, it was hard to feel joyful when there's so many things, terrible things going on, and not just in Palestine and, you know, in Ukraine and in Africa and in our own communities. There are things happening that we're not joyful about. So I understand how hard it is some days to feel joyful. So we are challenged with just being joyful, right? If we can't find it, can we be it? Can we just be it, right? Just be joyful. So can you find joy in just the simple things of life? One of the most joyful parts of my day is when I get up and I go downstairs and I have a good cup of coffee. How many of you can relate to that one? Yeah. All right, a good cup of coffee, a call from a dear friend, your cat purring on your lap, your dog wagging its tail. coming here to this home, right? Coming home, this is our home. When I walk through these doors, it doesn't matter what I had going on out there. It's like the smile just comes on my face, and we see each other, and we feel this joy to be with each other, and that's why we come here. There's a story. I'm in a course right now, a Unity course, for part of being a minister here, and I'm taking the second course in my studies on prosperity. And so we're reading the Lynn Twist book, which is The Soul of Money. It's my second time reading this book. And there's a story in there. She started the End Hunger Project. I don't know if that's the exact name of it. But she's going to this Senegalese, I'm going to mispronounce that, but she's going to this area out in the farthest western desert part of Senegal to meet with this tribe to help them because they are desperate. They have no food and they're running out of water. And so she's expecting to find, you know, people who are literally joyless. Right? What do they have to be joyful for? And as she gets closer and closer, the Jeep gets closer and closer to the village, these children come running and they're playing and they're literally jumping for joy, smiling and welcoming her. And she was like, she was shocked. She's like, what do these people have to be joyful for? But they were joyful for their community. They were joyful to be alive. They were joyful because that was just their nature. That was just their nature, to be joyful. So they were also joyful because they were grateful for what they have and the opportunities that they have. So joy springs from a grateful heart. So the key to unlocking joy is really to recognize and appreciate the good that you do have. Right? We have so many things to be grateful for, but we get stuck in what we don't have. And I'm guilty of that just as much. We have so many positive things as well in our life. And, you know, there's so many stories, and you can talk to people, and they've got all kinds of stuff going on in their lives, things that they, you know, anybody else would think, wow, I would be miserable and depressed if I was in your situation. There's a story about a woman, she was 85, 86, I don't know, she had was recovering from cancer, she had a broken leg. Her husband had died when she was 40, and she had to raise 5 kids on her own, lost her home, and so she was living in just a tiny little studio. And a friend would call her and say, how you doing? And she's like, I'm so great. Life is wonderful. I'm sitting in my garden just listening to the birds. I'm so grateful for the time I have left. I'm just appreciating life. And here's somebody who, from the outside, you would think, wow, what do they have to be grateful for? And yet, in just the simple little things, we can find gratitude and feel joyful. We don't need to wait for, you know, things out there to happen for us to be joyful. So it is found in the simple little things, just like Nick sung in his song, right? Happiness is waking up. Happiness is the flowers that are blooming all around us. Happiness is the sun that's shining, even though it's pretty hot. I know some people that absolutely love the heat because they go to the beach or they go to the mountains because that's what brings them joy. So I want you to think about the simple little things that you have right now in your life that are joyful. Simple, simple little things that bring you joy. And when we give thanks, we start to appreciate more things. And we start to see life through a different lens. And it does nobody any good if we're walking around with sad, you know, pusses on our face. I couldn't think of the term, the expression I wanted to say, but you know what I mean, right? If we're not radiating positivity, we are radiating negativity. And, you know, we want to be able to raise our vibration. This is energy month, so it is all about energy. So if we want to raise our vibration and be more joyful, You know, if we can't be it, maybe we need to find ways to experience joy. So having a gratitude journal. How many of you have gratitude journals? Yeah, look around the room, for there's a lot of grateful folks out here. And you know what? You don't have to have a journal to be grateful, obviously. Right? Express gratitude to somebody. Make a pact, a decision, that every day you're going to appreciate at least one person. There's a practice where once an hour, you just think of somebody in a positive way. And notice how differently you feel at the end of the day. So have a joy journal, have a joy practice. Now, lesson two, right? Or part of our overall lesson. Joy is an inside job. Just like happiness is a state of mind, joy is who we are. It's what we are. And we can decide to be as happy as we want or as unhappy as we want. Although I don't think anyone really sits down and says, you know what, I'm just going to be unhappy today. We might wallow in stuff. Anybody wallow in stuff? Yeah, we do. It's part of, you know, the human condition, I guess. You know, so joy isn't always found out there, though. It isn't always found out there, and yet it is, but it's transitory. Obviously, we can do things that bring us joy. We can spend time with people that bring us joy. But joy is an energy, and it's a power, and it's contagious. Now, interestingly enough, there's a lot of research on happiness and joy, and as a matter of fact, one of my favorite books, The How of Happiness, talks quite a bit about how we can be happier and what we can do to be more joyful. And interestingly enough, but our own intrinsic joy we're born with, but it's only 50%. So you think about all the different personalities in the world, and some people just are naturally, you know, joyful, and some people just walk around not as much so. So only 50% of that is genetics. The rest of it, we have control over. 40% of our joy we can create for ourselves. And so one of my favorite practices, you know, these intentional activities that bring us joy, one of my favorites is savoring. Savoring. So savoring is actually thoughts or behaviors to generate prolonged enjoyment. Yes. Prolonged enjoyment. So that means in the moment when you are experiencing something that you enjoy, really give it your full attention, right? All five senses, just savor that. How many of you savor some meals and foods that you like? Yeah. So instead of wolfing it down because you're hungry, savor every bite, right? The texture. The flavors of the spices, you know, as you take it in on your plate, right? Really think about the food and enjoying it. Take more time. So when you're in the present, you really are focusing on and capturing the joy so that in the past, you can bring back those joyful moments and rekindle them from memories. So another way to have more joy in our lives today is to spend time thinking about joyful times in the past, right? Your last year's vacation, or when your children were a certain age, or different experiences in your life that have brought you joy. When we spend time thinking about those, we feel joyful now as well. And so the third piece of savoring is the future. So instead of being, you know, having dread about the future, can we have joyful anticipation? And isn't sometimes the anticipation even better than the thing? So remember that, right? Really savor thinking about the thing. And that's really the key to savoring, past, present, and future. So if you're looking for a way to tap into being more joyful, use that tool. So raise your energy. You attract what you radiate. So of course, the more joyful we are, look around. This room is filled with joyful people, All right, so let's just keep radiating that and bring in more and more and more. And if you're watching us online, thank you so much, and keep watching, and we'll bring in more people and more people as well. So ask yourself, what am I radiating? Is it joy or is it junk? Yeah, let's get rid of that junk. Let's just kind of have the junk guy come and pick it up. I don't know what they do with it, but let's just have the junk guy come pick it up. Think about who's in your life. Are they light beings or are they vampires? Right? Vampires are those, you know, people that zap your energy and they suck it out of you. So when you're dealing with a human challenge as well, if you're focused on, you know, not enough money, not enough love, not enough time, that's the one that zaps my energy. Oh, I just don't have enough time for everything. Or if we're in the too much, oh, there's too much stress, there's too much strife, there's too much sickness. The not enoughs and the too muches zap our energy. So stop complaining. Let's go back to focusing on what's working. There's that gratitude piece. When you hear yourself complain about something, recognize that you're zapping your own energy and that's what you're radiating, emptiness. So what can we do to raise our vibration? Actually, what I'm doing right now, everybody raise your arms up. We can, right? Even just putting your hands up in the air raises your vibration, raises your energy. So smile. Simple thing, just smile. I know, I love your smile. Right, everybody take, just smile at each other. Just look around the room and just smile at each other. I know. It's like, oh, she's making us do that again. Right, smile, laugh, sing, dance, jump. There's so many things we can do as physically to raise our vibration. So, lesson three, life is meant to be enjoyed. It is meant to be enjoyed. I think we have it all backwards. I really do. I think we have it backwards. We live a life where we work hard. We do things we don't necessarily want to do because we need the paycheck. We need to pay the bills. We need to raise our kids. And we need to do all those things. And then we can enjoy our life, right? Or we work hard all day and stuff we don't want to do, and then we enjoy ourselves for the few hours in the evening. Why? Life is meant to be enjoyed all the time. It is a choice. It is our birthright. It's our divine birthright to be joyful. I think we forget that when we're stuck in the mud. And I have to remind myself of that too. I have a very busy career. You know, this is one part of my life. I have a business, I have a family, I have friends, I have myself that I want to spend time with. And we get so busy, and we're not enjoying ourselves. And so we have to pull back sometimes and say, what are my values? What interests me? What impact do I want to make in the world? Who do I want to be? That's the first question I ask myself when my alarm goes off in the morning. And actually, the alarm says, good morning, beautiful. It's time to get up. And it says, today is the best day ever. I have like three different alarms that go off just to make sure that I get up. And I have shared that once before, what my alarms say. But it's, you know, before I jump out of bed, I try to remind myself, how do you want to be today? Especially when I know I've got a really busy day that's going to drain my energy. So how do I want to be? I want to be joyful. I want to be peaceful. I want to enjoy the work that I do. So what can I do to make sure that is the case? Remind yourself, life is meant to be enjoyed. Tap back into what is the purpose? What is the passion for what you do? And if you've lost that, find a way to reconnect. Find a way to bring the joy back. And again, it's that simple things in life, that cup of coffee, the cat sitting, you know, outside on your balcony or wherever it is, simple things that bring us joy. So one of my favorite quotes here as well, there is no destination. The journey is all there is, and it can be very, very joyful. If we decide, right, if we decide. So once again, just from a show of hands, how many of you are now still waiting to be happy? Very good. Oh my God, me. Thank you for your honesty. Because you know what? There is no there. There is no there. There's a here and now. I was just watching a thing on YouTube that Jose put on about time, right? And all the different theories about time. Like there is no time. There's the past, the present, the future, all at once. Right? So there is no there. There's just here. There's just here and now. This is it. This is it. This is what we got. And in the pursuit of happiness, though, right, on that journey to the destination that says, when I get there, I'll be happy. I'll be joyful. I'll be done working. I'll be so happy, right? Or the kids will be out of the house, or I'll have won the lottery, or you fill in the blank for yourself, right? That there, we stumble, we fall. And that, you know, we scrape our knees and we get stitches and, you know, we have all kinds of things that happen that makes the journey not so joyful anymore. And yet when we recognize that life is the journey, right? Life is the journey. So going back to the beginning, why wait then to be joyful if the journey is our life? Why not be joyful every single day? You know, and this is vacation season. So how many of you are planning a vacation or a trip somewhere? Right, if hands go. Some of you probably already went on one. Some of you spent all year going on them. So this was my big lesson. I'm a big planner, and I do really savor the planning. I've learned that over the years, to savor the planning, savor the anticipation. But then I'd get in the car, and I'd be like, ugh, it's a 7-hour drive. Woo! Energy! Wow. And you know, this started as a kid, because it was actually a 6-hour drive from Long Island to Pennsylvania to go to my grandmother's house. And I think my parents knew that if they didn't have something for us to focus on, it was not going to be a fun journey. So I learned really young about the license game. My parents would give out money, like if we found license plates from different states, and if we found Hawaii or Alaska, like, whoa, that was a dollar. Like it was like 10 cents, 25 cents, and it would go up depending upon how far away. And we'd always have this battle about if we saw a truck, because a truck always had like multiple license plates on it, and we could tick off about 5 states just like that. Right? So, you know, when you recognize that the journey is your life, and, you know, whether you're on a long plane ride, I had 3 different planes last couple weeks ago to go to Denmark, and it was a 24-hour journey to get to my friends. And in thinking about it, I knew that I wanted to arrive refreshed and in a joyful headspace. So what could I do on that journey? Right? Listening to music, bringing my blanket and my pillow so I was comfortable on the plane, right? Thinking about all the ways that I could stay in that joyful, you know, state of mind, even though traveling can be very stressful. So when we're coming into doing things that, you know, the journey seems arduous, remind yourself, yeah, but the journey is life. Does the flower, as it's coming, you know, up through the ground, is it thinking to itself, oh, this is going to be such an arduous journey to push through and come up and finally bloom? No, as I'm watching this one plant, Rich, remind me, is it deciduous or the other one that comes up every year? Perennial, thank you. It's dormant and then it reblooms again. And I'm watching this one, which we didn't know when it was, I got it as a Mother's Day gift like 2 years ago, and it was this brilliant, brilliant, bright purple, pink flowers that came up. And when it died, I felt so sad, but I didn't want to let it go. I just kind of let it sit in the pot. And then the next year it came up again, so I was like, oh, wow. So this year I'm watching it come up, and little by little by little by little, I'm watching it. And there is so much joy in that. I never imagined that just watching this flower start to go through its different stages to get to full bloom would bring me so much joy, just like my very first tomato that I grew. My beefsteak tomato, I'm telling you, I felt like a little kid, like my very first tomato. So simple things, just like going for a bike ride. We rented some bikes in Carolina Beach a couple weeks ago. It was so hot. Oh my God, we picked one of the worst weather days to do that. And when we get on the bikes, my daughter says, well, where are we going? I said, I don't know. I literally had no destination. I said, we're just going to ride. We're just going to zigzag in and out of the neighborhoods. We're just going to have a joyful day riding bicycles. And I don't know about them, but I had a joyful day. So, in reviewing our lessons, number one, don't wait to be joyful. Remember that joy is internal and we should always enjoy the journey and those little moments. So if you are game, you're welcome to stand up with me and finish with our with our affirmation. You can also jump from joy in your seat. So everybody ready? Oh boy, I am jumping for joy. Yeah. Thanks everyone. So it is time to jump for joy and generosity. And so once again, we have a number of different ways that you can be generous to Unity of Wilmington. And remember, what we give, we receive. So let's do our mudra. Now, there we go. Ready? Divine love through me blesses and multiplies all that I am, all that I give, and all that I receive. And so it is. That these blessings in the basket go forth to heal, prosper, and bless. And I know that each and every one of us is jumping for joy to live a life that is abundant, joyful, peaceful, and calm. And with that, I release my word, knowing it's done. Together we say, and so it is. Thank you. All right, so it is my joyful opportunity once again to invite Nick back up. Come on. Oh, no. So sorry, you can applaud him, it's okay, but we're gonna do announcements next. I'm still getting used to the change in our service rotation there, so come on up, Shirley.
All right, everybody, it's time for our announcements. I have a whole stack of them, and for those of you online, if you'd like to find out more about what we're doing at Unity in Wilmington, you can go to our website, our calendar's there, list everything that we need to do. You don't need to be a member to participate, so please come out and join us for some of these activities. Today at 12:30 in our sanctuary, we have kirtan with Madhavaya. There's a love offering. If you're not sure what kirtan is, it's call and response. It's meditative chanting and prayer. She does some drumming as well. It's a very uplifting experience, so please come and try it out. Next, we have a drumming circle Saturday the 29th from 3 to 4. Bring your drums and join us. There will be drums here as well if you do not have your own. Next, on the 30th from 1 to 2:30, there is a pop-up healing energy. No experience required to give and receive healing. There is a love offering for that event. Next, we are in need of volunteers for our AV production team to be a substitute on Sundays. You will be trained for that, so if you are interested, see Jose after the service. We also need some new members for our hospitality team. We need people to set up and to clean up. That does not have to be the same person doing both things. Just once a month, so please see Gail O'Brien if you are interested in doing that. We could also use some more food for our table. It does not have to be homemade. You can get it from the supermarket when you come, and just drop that off when you come to the service, and our hospitality team will put that together. We could also use a new teller. They are the people that count the offerings after church as a team of two people. So if you're new to this, don't be worried that you won't know what you're doing. We'll help you out with that. All right, so what's new? We are in a place where we would like to rent out our space for community events. So we've got the sanctuary, which seats 150 people. The community room is a little meeting room in the back, freshly painted, seats 80, and then the parlor across the way seats 30. So go to our website to make reservations if you're interested in doing that. Next, we would like to recognize our volunteer teams. This week, we're recognizing our building team, prosperity team, and our teller team. If you are a part of any of those teams, please stand up. Thank you for your service. Now, if you are looking for our SOAR into 2024, you notice that it is not there, but it is still in the room. So we moved it over there. This is the opportunity to share your joys, your victories, of some of the things that just have brought you delight. You've set your goal, you've accomplished that. So go up and put that on the post-it note, put it on the board, and we can all rejoice with you for those accomplishments. All right. Any more announcements from the floor? I think we've covered them all here. All right, now we're going to hear from Nick. Come on up.
Watch my every step. Find a sturdy branch, don't you dare look down. Pull your body up, dig in your heels. Let's see what this tree reveals. Just a few more feet, we're almost at the top. Watch the robin's nest. Pull your body up till you've broken through. Let's see if this tree has a view. At the top, at the top, at the top of the world, you're drawing back a curtain. At the top, at the top, at the top of the world, there you know for certain you're alive and you are free. So follow me to the top of the world. Mountains to the west, an ocean to the east, a storm cloud to the north, ready to pour. Every sycamore leaves me wanting more and more. At the top, at the top, at the top of the world, my head and heart are pounding. At the top, at the top, at the top of the world, I hear my voice resounding. I'm alive and I am free, so look at me. You've gotta see it to believe it, and believe me, I've seen it. The frontier of the upper atmosphere, a wonder to behold it, a story yet untold. It's up here, up here, up here. I'll go out on a limb. I'll walk the tightrope wire to the highest height. Yes, I'll risk it all. Give me a barrel. Guess who will find a waterfall? At the top, at the top, at the top of the world, my head and heart are pounding. At the top, at the top, at the top of the world, I hear my voice resounding. I'm alive and I am free, so look at me. At the top of the world.
Oh my God, if that doesn't have you wanting to jump for joy, I don't know what would. Well, this has been such a joyful service. Thank you, everyone, for coming today and for watching online. I just am filled with so much joy, and I do feel like I'm on the top of the world. Let's give Nick another round of applause. And I think that's a beautiful high note to finish our service on. So let us together do our prayer for protection. So, and then you can join with me. Light of the world surrounds us. I am the light of God. The love of God molds us. I am the love of God. The power of God protects us. I am the power of God. The presence of God watches over us. I am the presence of God. Wherever we are, God is, and all is well. That peace out into the world. Be generous with your joy and enjoy your day. Also, please enjoy some fellowship next door, and especially if you are new, this is your first time in Wilmington, we will seek you out and welcome you. Have a wonderful day, everyone. Namaste.
Namaste.